I did go through and check out like who did some Khan Academy and I added those grades in. I'm going to extend it over. I the students who did do it, they only did one set of questions, or I think one student did two sets of questions. I just wanted to let you know every set of questions goes towards your grade, so you have to do more than one set. Maybe they just were trying it to see what it's like, and then they're going back to it. Right, so the standard I wanted you to write for number one is write a quadratic function to represent the relationship between two quantities from a graph, a written description, or a table of values within a mathematical or real-world context. So as I write number two, this qualifies as a written description. So we're going to write the equation based on this written description, and this is our standard that we're covering here. So did you guys label the standard as number one so that it's easy on your Bible quiz if I say the standard number one? And then I'm labeling the word problem number two, but on your Bible quiz I'll put on number four, page 83. Alright, a player hits a soccer ball from a height of 2 feet. The ball reaches the maximum height of 20 feet after traveling 40 feet horizontally and is caught by the goalkeeper 70 feet from where it was kicked. The path of the ball can be modeled by a parabola. Y is the height and X is the distance. At what height does the goalkeeper catch the ball? Alright, so let me write this data down. So it's x comma y, and x is distance, and y is height. Alright, so this first statement already tells me an ordered pair. Can anybody write an ordered pair from a player hits the ball from a height of 2 feet? That's an x, y value on a parabola. Camden? 0, 2. We have a point. Alright, let's do it again. The ball reaches the maximum height of 20 feet after traveling 40 feet horizontally. Can anybody write that out as an ordered pair? Damn it. It went 40 feet horizontally. That represents the distance. And the height was 20. Now this is a vertex. This max height has this vertex. What letters on a Friday did we discuss represent vertex?
H and K.
H and K. Okay, H comma K. Alright, so you guys have your steps from Friday. You know, if you had a hard time pulling that information out of the word problem, here it is. This is XY and this is HK. Try to begin those steps. I'd love to see you get through step four on your own. Step five is great. Step six is top notch, you know? Actually, is the bell ringing? Number one was to write this. And then number two is this problem. And you can ask, as I walk around, if you're not sure where I got the 2, the 0, the 40, or the 20 from, please let me know. Order of operation. Since I have 2 numbers in here, I'm going to go ahead and subtract them. I don't have to distribute or anything like that. I can really actually just subtract it. It's the easiest way.
Thank you.
All right, so you should have got either negative 0.1125 or negative 9 over 800 for A. Anybody get the A value right? Anybody need me to zoom on a step? All right, that completes steps 1 through 4. I'm going to do it all over again. This class is becoming very, very annoying if you don't have a calculator. I'm just sitting here like wondering what the numbers are. Very annoying with the calculator. So I have now plugged in A, H, and K. That was step 5. I have to actually finish it. No, that is step 5. Step 5 done. Ashley, did you get step 5 right? Yeah. Did you use the decimal or the fraction?
Fraction.
Yeah. Alright, so now because there's an x in these parentheses, now I have to do a little side job and FOIL that. So I'm gonna kind of ignore the fraction, ignore the 20, and do the FOILing in the middle. Kelton, did you do this FOILing yet?
No.
Okay, I'm gonna pause and let you go ahead. Your calculator will not FOIL a binomial.
What?
I've never tried it, right? But I'm not sure.
If you have a hooked calculator,
who's got it? Hunter. Are you done?
What?
I'm done. Good job. Who feels like they have the equation done?
Yeah.
I'm not sure if FOIL on your calculator.
I don't think it does it.
Does not do it for you. Actually, it will do it wrong. Actually, it'll make you think it's doing it. We give it the wrong number. Alright, sign up with x squared minus 40x minus 40x plus 1600. X squared minus 80x plus 1600. Because I did x times x. I did x times 40. I did 40 times x and I did 40 times 40. Alright, so now I successfully FOILed. Now I have to bring in this funky looking fraction and this plus 20. This guy is still in parentheses with this weirdo fraction and a plus 20 at the end. Weirdo fraction. How dare you?
This is real data, though, guys. Does that soccer ball really go 40 feet and hit a maximum height of 20 feet and start at 2 feet? Yes, this is the real parabola for that soccer ball. So that's why it's a annoying fraction instead of an easy number. Real data. Alright, I'm going to distribute this fraction and I'm going to multiply it here, here, and here. It doesn't go all the way up to that 20. Yeah. This is the fraction of one. Yes? Minus what?
I got,
Yeah, your times and the negative and.
Oh, the B value is positive. You're absolutely right, two negatives and a positive, thank you, damn man. Other ones. Okay, now did anybody get this? Either the decimal or the fraction form before me? So five or six. Alright, starting with the verbal description, only two pieces of data about this soccer ball. We now have something we can put into decimals and actually see exactly where this soccer ball is going. Who cares about soccer balls, right? Like, maybe it's an airplane or something you care about. Maybe it's a cannonball. Bow and arrow. At what height does the goalkeeper catch the ball? Was there any information given in the verbal description about the goalkeeper and the ball? Yes?
He's probably 70 feet from where it was pitched.
70 feet from where it was pitched. Does that represent distance or height? Where are we going to put 70? An X spot or a Y spot? Alright, so this is the information they gave us about the goalkeeper. He was 70 feet away, and they want us to find height. So distance is X. We're looking for a Y value. Will probably ask you to then use the equation. That's what just happened. It asked us to write the equation, and then it gave us something to try to figure out. Now use your equation to answer this. This will tell us the height of the goalkeeper. Okay, so this is the equation that where's your sentence or where you want the goalkeeper caught the ball 9 feet up? Can you guys catch the ball 9 feet high? So, I feel like I can. You can. Do you not know how you can catch the ball? No. Well, how tall are you with your arms up?
How tall can you reach without your
legs?
7 foot. So you have that.
goalkeepers are really tall. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Question. Okay.
Alright, go ahead and check number 10.
Six, 4, 1, and 9. You got the first step. So you got all the way through step 4 correctly. That's awesome.
Just like me.
So I'm gonna do minus and negative two.
Stop bringing that up.
Minus and negative that's gonna turn that to a
six. You might have all of this work down for it, but again, so if it was a 7-point question, you were successful.
Alright, who's got a question? This test is only 4 sections, and we're in the middle of section 3, so we only have one more section to do before your test next Wednesday.
I was going to offer for this quiz coming up Wednesday an open note option, but it'll be at a cost. It'll be like, it'll cost you 15% to use your notes.
So what that means... What that means is you could get an 85%,
right? So if you're at like a 60 or a 50 on the quizzes and tests, and you know if you had your notebook, you could do better, you're going to use your notebook. I'm not going to take any off of you. It's not like a, like you do it and then I subtract 15. It's that you cap at 85, right? So so if you do it open note, the highest score you can get is an 85%, which is a B, which is great. Okay, but if you're shooting for that A, you need to have it memorized and know how to do it.
That's what I'm looking at. Sometimes I do 18%. I'll let you know when Tuesday
comes.
Yeah.
What, like,
is
going to be on the
next
just this?
Or yeah, listen. What's on the mini quiz on Wednesday? You will have to grab a quadratic in standard form.
You will do those steps there. You will have to do, this that we're doing today, you're going to have to do what I'm showing you tomorrow, which is the same section. And then that's pretty much it. That's pretty much it. This is put out by the state and the county, so you can count, and I posted this on Schoology for you guys. So here's chapter 2. It's supposed to be done within like 26 days. We're about a week behind right now. Okay, so this is the honor schedule. Now, if you compare yourself to a person in a regular Algebra 2 class who's not getting the honors extra 0.5% in their GPA, their schedule's a little bit slower. Okay. But even with this, we are 7 days behind already in chapter 2. So I know it might feel like we're learning really quickly, but I have taught this class a long time. And I do talk to the ACE math teacher, and I am very aware of what's on the SAT. So I'm making decisions based on what I hear from you and what I see here. Okay. Also, there are students currently with over 100%. So I have to like make sure that those students are being challenged. Do your best to keep up.
And if you're not, get on contact. We have options. Alright, I'm going to start at page 85, number 1. Right, all of these problems can be done using the same steps from Friday and the same steps we just did. On number 1, you have to figure out what is the vertex. It doesn't tell you. What's the vertex? It doesn't tell us. Has anybody figured out the vertex besides the script? Not you guys. You guys don't say it. I know you're not. You guys read the book.
Okay.
Yeah, this indicates a low point or a high point. If it hits a point and then repeats, that one in the middle is the vertex. This is symmetry here. They're symmetrical around that vertex. So if you see it go up and then back down or down and back up, that's your vertex.
I'm going to work through those steps. Okay.
Don't copy me. Break the point you got and you do it.
I'm just focusing on these parentheses in my brain myself and foiling. Alright, you guys, I'm leaving you with 4 more practice problems. Please come in after school if you want. You can get all 4 done here after school, okay? So I did 1 with you. I will check your paper tomorrow to make sure you have number 1 done. I want you to do 3, 6, and 7. And a word problem number 13. Okay?